Joining us now in Hot Copy, we have with us House Quad Committee Chairperson and Surigao del Norte Representative Robert Ace Barbers. Good morning, Congressman. Thanks for making time for us.
Good morning, Katrina, and thank you for having me. Magandang umaga po sa ating mga kababayan.
All right, Congressman Barbers, before we go into the details on what the QuadCom plans to tackle next, let's first talk about the allegations made by Mr. and Mrs. Roque against you. Mrs. Roque, in particular, released a statement calling you as an abusive individual for allegedly spewing libelous statements against her. Your comment on this first.
Well, they should get all the facts straight. No, I don't know where they get all this information that they can review. Naman all the hearings. No, it's all posted in social media, and they can even my interviews. No, I've never issued any libelous statement against Rock, Harry, or Myla. No, they're probably being fed the wrong information. So again, you check your facts.
Okay. Mrs. Roque also claims that the Quad Committee never accepted any of her medical certificates and hospital records, justifying her medical condition and her trip to Singapore for treatment. Why did the Quad Committee allegedly refuse to admit these documents coming from Mrs. Roque?
No, it was all accepted and admitted by the QuadCom. However, one of the co-chairs of the QuadCom, Congressman Caraps Paduano, asked for more details about her medical condition, no? Because apparently what Mrs. Roque has submitted are just mere laboratory results, no, from a certain Clinica Manila. And most of the members of the committee did not find it satisfying, no? So that's why there was emotion to ask for more information. And, you know, I'm the chair of the committee, and I would always rule on emotion being posed by a member, especially from a co-chair, no? And, you know, that's the reason why we demanded for more information.
Mm-hmm.
Not believing is a different thing, no? We do accept the submissions that she made. And these are all laboratory results, and we do accept that. However, there's a need for more information regarding her status. I don't know. There was a motion made by Congressman Paduano about that.
Okay. Congressman Barbers, this means that she did not actually give you or state what kind of illness she's suffering from, on why she needs to travel to Singapore for treatment, and basically no explanation as well as to why she needs to get the treatment abroad instead of going to hospitals here in the Philippines?
No, she just wrote a letter to the members of the Quad, and to the chairman of the QuadCom, saying that she's not fit, she's not well, and she has just undergone a surgery or an operation, no? But nothing in that letter, in that excuse letter, that says that she will travel abroad to seek medical another surgery. No, wala, there's nothing in that letter. We invited her on our third hearing. No, she did not appear. So because she wrote to us and said that she can't make it because she just undergone a surgery or a medical procedure. No, I don't remember exactly what it says there in that letter. And in that same letter, in that same day, no, Attorney Harry Roque, I think, was present. And he said that he's more than willing to answer questions that we posed at Mrs. Roque. And we accepted that. Now, if they're claiming that I abuse my parliamentary immunity and issue libelous statements, I think they should get their facts correctly.
Congressman Barbers, does the committee have any information with regard to where Mrs. Roque is right now? Has she returned to the Philippines? Has she finished her treatment in Singapore? And what kind of treatment did she get in Singapore?
Well, honestly, I have no idea if she did seek a medical treatment abroad. No? But as far as we are concerned, and we were informed by the BID, Bureau of Immigration, that September, first week of September, she traveled to Singapore. And that was the last location that we had that information on. No? This is an information shared with us by the Bureau of Immigration, because right after the third or fourth hearing of the Quad, there was already a issuance of a show cause order. No, No, on the fifth pala. Well, there was already an issuance of a show cause order. Again, this was moved and asked by a co-chair of the Quadcom. So, siguro they're probably getting the information wrongly. And I don't know where they're getting it from, no? Or probably somebody else is feeding that to them. So, you know, alam mo, kaibigan ko yan si Harry, mabait naman yan eh. All we needed was just for him to submit all the documents required of him that he promised, that he offered, and he volunteered. So, you know, I'm sorry about what's going on with their family now. No? I'm really sorry. We have no intention to whatever it is that caused what is happening to them. No, nothing of that sort.
Based on the developments that you see coming from the side of Mr. and Mrs. Roque, would it be fair to describe the couple as being evasive amid this congressional investigation?
Yeah, it looks like it. No, looks like it. Attorney Harry Roque is trying to evade appearing before the committee and sharing with us what he knows, what was asked of him. No? In fact, Katrina, all this information was asked by Congresswoman Jinky Luistro and Congressman Rog Gutierrez. Again, no, I'd like to emphasize that I'm the chair of the Quad, I'm the lead chair of the Quadcom. And of course, if there are any motions posed by a member of the committee, the chair is compelled to rule on the motion. Mm-hmm. And in that particular hearing where all these documents were required of Attorney Roque, he even in fact stated that he was more than willing to share this information and all these documents to the Quadcom. Mm-hmm. So parang nakitwist ngayon. Parang kami ngayon na nagde-demand ng something na hindi required. So that those documents were required of him because he was the one who said that these documents are present. These documents are available and he's willing to share it with the committee.
Mm-hmm. Former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque has repeatedly mentioned in public statements that he has already lost faith in the fairness of the Quad Committee, saying that the only reason why the House panel has been trying to pin him or link him to the illegal gambling operations in the Philippines is because of his alliance or allegiance with the Duterte family. Your thoughts on that statement of Attorney Roque?
That's far from the truth, no? That's far from the truth. I would advise my friend, Attorney Harry Roque, not to think of himself as a central political figure, no, in this issue. And the Quad has never used the committee for any political persecution. Alam mo, imagination lang niya yan, eh. Imagination lang ng ibang mga kasama niya, eh, no? So, wag naman, no? Alam mo, I think Attorney Harry Roque knows that what the Quad is doing is within the bounds of our rules, no? And we have not violated any law, no, for that matter. Now, if there was any law that was violated in the conduct of the Quadcom hearings, I suggest that he question this before the appropriate court, diba? But in the meantime, what we really want to get and hear from him are answers to the questions posed by Congresswoman Luistro, Congressman Rog Gutierrez, Congressman Paduano with respect to the information where allegedly he is being implicated on the operations of the Lucky South 99. Diba? Kung if this can be refuted, why not? Diba? We will give him all the opportunity. Wala kaming ibang intention dito but to ferret out the truth. Ang katotohanan lamang ang aming gustong malaman.
Congressman Barbers, I understand that Attorney Roque will indeed file a petition before the Supreme Court, if not today, mm-hmm. then this week. But let's talk about the Duterte family. Representative Paulo Duterte earlier wrote to the committee expressing interest to join the proceedings. I just find it quite amusing for him to have the courtesy to even write to the committee, because based on experience from covering congressional investigations, usually House members just arrive there and sit and then be given the courtesy to ask questions. What kind of questions do we expect to hear from Representative Duterte? Have you talked to him beforehand before the hearings resume?
Well, I have no idea, really. What questions will be raised, no, during the committee hearing? But again, you're correct. All members of the 19th Congress are always welcome to attend any committee hearings, much more the Quadcom hearings. No? We will welcome that. And yes, that's true. He wrote to us a letter, and we have replied to that letter already, saying that the next Quadcom hearing, where issues of allegations hurled against our colleague Congressman Paulo Duterte must be answered, no? We will probably schedule that soon, no? We don't really know as to when, because there are four issues that the Quadcom is tackling at the moment, and these are issues that are of national importance. And we want to make sure that we will be thorough, we will be comprehensive in our discussions of all these topics. That's why it's hard to really schedule as to when the next schedule of the hearing will be, and the difficulty in determining what topic are we going to deliberate on.
Okay. Another personality that is expected to attend the Quadcom hearings will be Alice Go. Speaking of which, we are showing right now on your screens live footage of Camp Krame, where Alice Go is expected to leave as she heads to the Pasig detention facility, to the Pasig City Jail, where she will be detained supposedly alongside Pastor Kiboloy's colleagues, who is also detained there. We are waiting word from our reporters on the ground to see if Alice Go will indeed be turned over to the Pasig City Jail today. But let's go back to our discussion, Representative Barbers. Representative Benny Abante earlier said that he will be presenting a matrix. I'm sure that he has discussed this with you already beforehand. How many personalities are we looking at?
Well, I don't have a count, no, as to how many personalities will be in that matrix. Yes, of course, he has discussed this matrix with us. In fact, we were involved in the information that we shared in writing and then coming up with that matrix. No? The Committee on Public Order and Safety, headed by Congressman Dan Fernandez, and Committee on Human Rights, headed by Congressman Benny Abante, and Committee on Public Accountability, headed by Congressman Paduano, has given inputs in writing that particular matrix. And we're having this matrix validated, no, by PIDEA, PNP, NBI, so that when we present this to the public, we would be able to say that all this information that we have in that matrix are all validated and verified information. As to the other personalities that might be involved, there could be, but we did not include that yet in our matrix that we will present maybe in the next hearing, because those information have not been verified yet.
Okay, but any high-ranking official that we should watch out for in that matrix, or any business leader or business personality possibly linked to any politician so far?
No, I cannot divulge that information at the moment, Katrina, because the verification process is still being done by the authorities. It's not us. We're not experts in the validation of all this information, but certainly there are business leaders that are involved in the matrix. And just to give you an information, some of those businessmen operating in the country are known to be associated with some personalities. And as long as this is verified and validated, then we'll be more than willing to bring it out to the open.
Without naming names, Congressman, what industries do these business leaders operate in?
A lot, several.
Any particular industry at that?
No, I cannot specifically say that they belong to this particular industry, because there are interlocking interests in several industries by these personalities.
Okay, possibly a conglomerate then.
Yeah, most likely. Yeah.
Okay, we will have to wait and see. But how soon can these information actually be verified and presented to the public?
Well, I really don't have any idea, because the experts are the ones doing that for us. We've asked them to help us in the validation of this information. And as to how fast they can do it, we really don't have any idea. Because, but one thing that we can share to the public are what legislation has the Quadcom already lined up in our committee report. No? And during our committee hearings, we always report, no, initially, what kind of legislation are we going to propose in the issue of POGO? What kind of legislation are we going to propose with the issue of extrajudicial killings, and so on and so forth? No? So, siguro, that's the only thing that we can probably do, no? At the moment. But as far as the validating information of people involved in illegal activities, we leave it up to the experts.
Mm-hmm. Another personality here, you have a very busy committee hearing in the coming days. You also have Tony Yang, the brother of Michael Yang, appearing before the Quadcom in the coming days. Has the panel already pre-interviewed Tony Yang, and what kind of information do we expect to get out of him?
No, we haven't done an interview with Tony Yang. I think he is under the custody of PAOK. And prior to his arrest, we've already discussed, no, what possible involvement he has in illegal POGO in Banban, probably drugs, drug trafficking or smuggling, because he operates a port in Cagayan de Oro. So there could be some involvement in, say, drug trafficking and other illegal activities. And that is why I said that we leave it up to the experts to make a validation on this information that we gathered.
Congressman Barbers, how willing is Tony Yang with regard to giving a tell-all, or at least answering questions during the Quad Committee? Because what we are concerned with is that he might take the track of former Bamban Mayor Alice Go, refusing to answer questions, basically giving the congressman nothing.
Including Cassie Ong, because that's their line. We all know that it's probably going to happen. But hopefully, if the member of Congress is skillful enough to elicit answers that may be included in our committee report, we will really appreciate that. But if not, and they go that route of saying I invoke my right against self-incrimination, then we will respect that, as we always do. That's why those people who are accusing us of not respecting their rights, they're probably wrong. No, they are all wrong, because we always make sure that our committee hearings are done within the bounds of law, and of course within the bounds of our rules.
Mm-hmm. Congressman, we're not sure with how cooperative Tony Yang will be. Alice Go, Cassie Ong refusing to give substantive answers to the committee. Former presidential spokesman Harry Roque refusing to attend the committee hearings. What is the panel actually doing to make sure that taxpayers' money, that government resources will not go to waste given the refusal of these key personalities to cooperate in these hearings?
Well, we will assure them it's not going to waste, to be wasted. The taxpayers' money will not be wasted in these QuadCom hearings because the main and primary objective of the committee is to propose legislation, because all these investigations or inquiries are in aid of legislation. And we will guarantee the Filipino people that we have several proposed legislation to make sure that all these criminal activities and illegal activities will not recur again, no, to the country. But as far as the criminal liability of all these resource persons that we have invited, we will leave it up to the proper agency, maybe perhaps the Department of Justice, because in our committee report, we will recommend the filing of charges for those people that we feel are liable in or enabling these illegal activities to proliferate in the whole country.
Okay,
and that is what we will guarantee the Filipino people, na hindi po nasayang ang inyong binayar ang buwis dito sa QuadCom.
Okay, Congressman Barbers, the Senate is already looking to wrap up its investigations into the illegal POGO operations here in the country. Mm-hmm. Is the House looking to do the same? Because we all know that time is of essence here. The filing mm-hmm. of the certificates of candidacy for the 2025 midterm elections is happening in a few days. Do mm-hmm. you have enough time to actually exhaust more information from key personalities? And how soon will you be able to finally put an end to these QuadCom hearings?
Well, this 19th Congress will end next year. And we're not limited as to we don't have a timetable as to when to finish this. Now, of course, we do understand that in the coming months, especially by next year, people or members of Congress will be very busy campaigning. But we don't want to miss the opportunity of conducting a thorough investigation and getting the necessary information to be able to achieve the objective of the QuadCom, which is to propose legislation and recommend perhaps people whom we find guilty or whom we find liable in these illegal activities, we would definitely recommend the filing of charges against them.
All right.
But since next week would be the start of the filing of certificate of candidacy and the Congress will go on break, we will not stop. We still will conduct hearings even on breaks. Kasi this is very important para po sa bayan ito. Gusto natin na the investigation will be thorough so that when we come out with the committee report, people will not question that this committee report has political motives. And we will assure you that there's nothing of that sort in this committee report that we will bring out to the public.
And we will have to wait and see and hope that you will have enough members to form a quorum in the coming months. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Congressman Robert Ace Barbers.
Thank you, Katrina. Thank you again for having me here in ANC.